So the first race of the weekend here at the September meeting at Donington Park for the Compact Cup is underway. It's a good start from our onboard camera. That's caught him by himself. He moves in front of at least three cars as they head down towards Redgate Corner for the first time. And it's Steve Roberts the lead, but he's under lots of pressure because Andrew Chang tries to come up on the inside. He was the pole man, but Steve Roberts leads out of Redgate. But trying to come alongside of Andrew Chang here, has to tuck in behind. Tom Onslow-Cole, one of our three guest drivers, goes side by side down the Craner curve. Tom Onslow-Cole, a seven-time race winner in the British Touring Car Championship. So down towards Redgate they go. Rob Boston there in fourth, putting the pressure on. Ryan Bensley, the ex-Stock Cats champion, as they go underneath Starkey's Bridge and head up towards McLean's for the first time of Arsene in this 13 minutes plus one lap race. And here comes a change just behind that, possibly. Not totally sure. I think that was Danny Winstanley and Martin Gambling getting side by side. Danny Winstanley, another guest driver, he normally races in GT Cup. Side by side as Rob Boston, the Lotus Elite racer and Master MX5 champion, tries to gain a position into Coppice. Now we can ride aboard with Kevin Edward. Now you can see how congested it is heading down towards the S's at the end of the Donington Park lap here. So they all get onto the brakes, try and work their way around the corner. As dive up the inside goes the number 65 machine in the hands of Simon Roach. Then the two cars will head side by side across the line to complete the first lap of this race, and they head down in towards Redgate then. The first time of racing speed, lap two, then they start, and it is on definitely. Tom Onslow-Cole trying to come up on the inside. This is the battle for fourth. Boston's gone through then, ahead of Bensley. Bensley's now ahead of Onslow-Cole, who goes ahead of Martin Gambling as they head now down to Hollywood, down the campaigners. Alex Dew there is next up. They turn through the left out of bottle with three wide further back through Hollywood. Then onto the brakes, they go for the old habit. Top three starting to make a break. The top two, Robertson Chan driving away as Tom Onslow-Cole now puts the pressure on Ryan Bensley. They go under Starkey's Bridge and then head up the hill up towards the left hander and Onslow-Cole on the inside. But then that'll be on the outside for McLean's. Ryan Bensley, the 2009, I think, Stock Hatch champion on the inside, and he stays in front of the British Touring Car race winner, who tries to come back up on the inside as they head into Coppice. But he's still behind Tom Onslow-Cole, the number 38 car, as this huge train of BMW Compact 318 head through Coppice, and we can ride on board with Colin Bysouth. He passed a car in the gravel trap there of Neil Broach. Alan O'Neill into the pit as well, so we have 26 cars still on track. 28 started, the biggest grid so far in the Gaz Shocks 750 Motor Club Compact Cup. As they head through the chicane, power back on, a few people kicking up the dust, running a bit wide out of the chicane. We head down towards Redgate yet again, and this battle is still on. We look at the front of that. Bensley and Onslow-Cole breaking the way, and Tom Onslow-Cole runs out of road. He's on the grass there. Further back, Kevin Denwood, one of our onboard canvases, following David Drinkwater, who's in the car that Ryan Bensley started the year in, the car built by Louis Tunmore. So from fourth back, they all headed the train into the old hairpin, then power on underneath Starkey's Bridge, then through the very fast left-hander, not really a corner, then up the hill to a tighter left-hander, more of a corner, before breaking again for McLean's. And still Ryan Bensley under all sorts of pressure from TOC as they now head up towards Coppice, and the two of them trying to break away from Martin Gambling. I think the Alex Dew behind as well, possibly, no, Danny Winstanley, then Alex Dew, then David Drinkwater before Kevin Denwood. Yeah, we've got a replay here, and with Mark Chang, road. Now see if we can try and work out who that was. Not 100% sure. Anyway, out of Redgate number 10, Alex Dew heads through the Craner curves now. He was the first person to win in the 2012 season. That's Tom Onslow-Cole on the tail into the old hairpin of the car of Anderson 4th, Ryan Bensley. A bit further up the road, though, it is Rob Boston, the 2010 Mazda MX-5 champion, the 2011 Mazda MX-5 Cup champion. Really puts the pressure on Andrew Chan. We ride on board of him into McLean. And up on the inside through Rob Boston, up to second. So Rob Boston then moving up is the first of our guest drivers. You see a novice cross on the back of the car. That's not for Rob, that's for Iggy Quatsey, who normally drives that car. So the car's onto the back straight then. What can Andrew Chan do to try and come back at Rob Boston? Well, Boston's been the fastest driver so far in this race. He's been about half a second or so quicker on average than Andrew Chan. So we expect perhaps Boston to be able to consolidate that position as we head through the chicane again. Now, can he close in the race leader? Steve Roberts, ex-Formula Ford racer, Northwest champion in Formula Ford. There's 1.2 seconds in it. We've completed four laps of what will probably be a 10-lap race. So can Rob Boston close in that gap? We'll have to see over the next few laps. Meanwhile, a bit further down in the back, we see Martin Gambling there, just behind Tom Onslow-Cole, who's losing time behind David Drinkwater, going side by side with Kevin Denwood, who's now just edging in front as they go into Hollywood. Now, will this give him the position before the crane? And I think it will, just behind Colin Bysack. Yeah, through goes Denwood. They head now down the hill towards around the outside of Bysack, but he can't do that. I think Drinkwater may be trying to attack from Denwood. He carries a lot more speed through the corner because Drinkwater was on that tighter line. Now, can Colin Bysack do anything about him as the cars head up towards McLean's then? First of all, through the left-hander, then they will go onto the brakes for the right-hander. Will the cars head out of view behind the trees? Meanwhile, we see the back in front, lit 8X in the corner. Here they come, Bysack under lots of pressure himself. Now, who's that behind the number 11 machine? That must be Terry Davies, I think. We can ride on board then with Colin Bysack, David Drinkwater just in front. Kevin Denwood started to break away. Down to the chicane then we go. I don't think this time will be a overtake opportunity. No crazy moves into the chicane. We sometimes see that. It's hitting the curb a bit too hard there with myself. Launching the car to new wheels. Slightly out of control, but that's no worry to him. Just further up the road, Alex Dew onto the attack of Danny Winstanley, who normally races a TVR. This car with a bit less power, but still getting sideways. And off the road goes Drinkwater, sideways with Roach. Through goes Mountain. Just behind them is Terry Davies as they head on to the crane. A curve yet again. David Power just behind them. He was a front runner at Brands Hatch in the first meeting of the year. So Kevin Denwood, David Drinkwater, Colin Bysack, the trio now breaking away from Dave Mountain. And now Roach is falling behind the 60 car of Terry Davies as they head underneath Starkey Bridge yet again and head up towards McLean. Denwood breaking away from Drinkwater, Bysack, and Ryan Bensley. His car's smoking, his car's slowing. Towards Onslow-Cole's up to fourth, and Ryan Bensley is retiring from the race as Alex Dew goes up on the inside into Coppice. He gains a position to Danny Winstanley, but we've lost the car of Ryan Bensley from the race then, which is a huge disappointment. Do I finish fourth? Who was running fourth before that? Let's have a look at a replay on board. Colin Bysack, who gets very sideways out of McLean's, losing time to David Drinkwater. And there you can see Ryan Bensley retiring his car from the race. Steve Roberts still leads to Rob Boston. That gap starting to come down now, though. It was 1.4 a couple of laps ago. It's less than a second now. You look a bit further back as Danny Winstanley runs out of road. Drinkwater's been closed back in by Bysack, so they now head on to Hollywood to start to go into the crane of curves yet another time in this race. Into the old hairpin they will go now, and Drinkwater slides the car off the road. He's on the grass. Is he going to be enjoying the car? Loops round and spins towards the tyre wall. David Drinkwater managed to keep it out of that, but now he's got to rejoin the circuit. Car slides again. I think very wet grass we have here at Donington Park, but he will rejoin the circuit, but much further down the pack. What a shame for David Drinkwater. On board with Colin Bysack then. Let's see how that all happened for him. into the old hair. I mean, the car just broke away at the beginning of the corner, then on the grass he was, then the car rotated as he tried to control the car. Late on to the brakes into Redgate though from Rob Boston as he closes in on Steve Roberts more and more. Andrew Chan can't go with the two of them, he still runs in third. Fourth on Onslow-Cole now, he still runs in now fourth, of course, after Bentley's retirement earlier. Alex Dew and Danny Winstanley battling for sixth. They're following Martin Gambling that sits in fifth position in the 99 car. Then we've got Denwood by South Mountain. As we look back towards the old hairpin as the battle goes on between Dew and Winstanley. David Power leading Simon Roach and Stuart Voice. Stuart Voice, the driver, just off the back of the grid because of a penalty of because of the contact between him and Steve Roberts at Anglesey in the last round of the series. So Stuart Voice heading up towards McLean's, getting himself back towards the top 10, and he should finish probably in the top 15. I think that's where he's running at the moment. Steve Roberts leading the pack still. For the penultimate time he turns through Redgate, and Rob Boston almost with him now. The gap after eight laps was 0.6 seconds. And it's Stuart Danny Winstanley sitting for seventh. Kevin Denwood runs out wide onto the grass he goes, calling by himself almost at the wide line, but they all got away with it. David Power now leads the next nice battle. Simon Roach, and there's Stuart Voice. This is the battle we were talking about last time. So they head through Hollywood, then onto the Craners. For what is the ninth lap? What will be 10? Last lap would be going out at the end of this. And here comes Roach. He's got the inside line to David Power. He squeezes up on the inside. He goes sideways. David Power pulled out the app, and Stuart Voice will go ahead of Roach. So Roach's attempt to remove that didn't work. So he now here, because the cars will be heading onto the last lap. Didn't he be thinking about a way passing? I mean, no, Voice won the fastest people in the series this year. So he'll be hoping to get back ahead of David Power. Right, leaders then. It's Steve Roberts. Can he hold Rob Boston off on this last lap of the race? He'll be hoping he can. The ex-Northwest Fauna Ford 1600 champion, Rob Boston, double Mazda MX-5 championship, first all in the Mark 1, then the Mark 3. He's just guessing this weekend. Steve Roberts has been racing these cars all year. Rob Boston did have a go last year at Cadwell Park, where he won the race there. So up towards McLean's then. Boston, perhaps a couple of car lengths behind Roberts at the moment. So here be maybe a lunge down the chicane. We'll have to wait and see. Third is Chang. Fourth is Onslow-Cole. Gambling still going after him. Alex Dew just behind him, as well as Danny Winstanley. And off the road, is that Voice? It is. Stuart Voice goes off the old hairpin. But into the chicane comes Andrew Chang. He's going to finish off the podium. He's the best of our onboard camera guards. But across the line, it's a change for the lead. Rob Bosner takes it. He wins. He beats Steve Roberts by half a tenth of a second. And Rob Boston only led the last 100 metres or so of that race, but he was the race winner. Steve Roberts have been really disappointed with that, but Rob Boston absolutely thrilled with the win. He beat Steve Roberts, like I said, by 0.05 of a second. Andrew Chang finished third. Tom Onslow-Cole in fourth. Like the BTCC race. Alex Dew and Danny Winstanley both found themselves ahead of Martin Gambling. The three of them separated by 0.06 of a second.